Hello, good day. My name is Dave. Have you ever wondered what are some of the basic things you need to get an investor for that your idea or your startup? You know, some people they just come up with something, an idea or just a quick product prototype, and they put a call through to their uncle, their senior colleague, friends, or whoever they feel that might be interested in investment or maybe a company or a team. And then at the end, once they relay the idea and the company rejects it, they be like, ah. So I'm like, what were they expecting? You know? Do you think that you just get your idea and then you just talk to someone and then they will just dump the money on you? Some people just think like that, but that's wrong. See, this guy has his hard-earned money, or this woman or this man, they have, or this team or this company, they have worked hard for this money. So when they are giving it to you in the name of investment, they're expecting that your business to generate that money back and then profit, and sometimes recurring profit. You understand? So once you understand it from this way that hey, these guys want profit too, they want their money back. You kind of understand the situation they find themselves in when they reject your idea. So if you are bringing an idea to an investor, here are the three basic things you need. Number one is statistics. What I call statistics in startup is how much are your product, you built it, because if you don't build it, I don't think there is even anybody that will look at you, because we don't have so excess money in this part of the country. We have people who just give you money and then tell you to go and work at it. You have 5 years, work at it. We just keep giving you money. Most investors in this part of the country, if your product is not making money from day one, nobody's investing on it. That's for the most part. So, first of all, you need statistics. How much is your product generating already? You built this product that does this amazing thing. How many users do you get? How many sales? If it's something that does not make sales, just acquire users. How many active users do you have? How many active users use your product? Not just registered users. Registered users is nothing. Active. How many? Okay, at what rate are they improving? That is statistics. So if you have a blog or something, how many subscribers, how many returning users do you have? I don't know if you're getting me. So these are statistics. If it's something that makes sales, how many sales do you make? What's the interval between each sale? You make like 2 sales per week. That's like 8 sales per month. The investor wants to hear this. Okay, every month you make 8 sales. And for the past 6 months, you have made so and so number of sales. Okay, if we give you 5 million, how much more sales will you make? That is statistics. If we give you 50 million, how much more sales? What's your profit per sale? So if we give you 50 million, how long will it take us to recover our 50 million, then start making profit? Those are the things the investor is calculating from their own point of view. So you need statistics. So get that product out, implement it, and get statistics back so you can present to the investor. So the next second thing you need is passion. This investor is actually giving out their hard-earned money. So they want to see that passion in you. They don't want to give out their money to someone that will just wake up one day, meet the first adversity and disappear, or just give up and go abroad to study for their masters or whatever, abandon everything. The 50 million naira they gave you disappears, everything. So they want to see passion. What have you done in this field before? What is your background relative to what you're doing? How passionate are you in this field? So they want to see that passion in you. Then the last one is that they want to see a team. If you're not a sole developer or anything, if you have a team, they want to see coordination with that team. They want to see distribution of labor. What do you do? What are your roles specifically, and how are you handling it, and what is the role of your partner or your co-founder or whoever ever? I don't know if you get, they want to see that team, because there is a mantra that even if the product fails and you have a good team, the good team can generate another product or a better product. But when you have a bad team, when the team fails, the product fails. So most investors want to see a good team. All right, so that is it. Do your documentation very well. The documentation is like your CV to speak for you when you are not there. Some people want to invest 5 million, but they feel this idea is great, so they need to forward something to their friends to get 5 million each, and at the end you have 25 million. You understand? Your document is what will speak for you. So document, good documentation, document. Don't just walk up to people and start accusing them for not investing in your destiny. Do a proper documentation. You understand? And so after presenting your view, you submit it to them. That is what will speak for you when you're not there. So thank you very much. I wish you success as you find your next investor. My name is Dave Partner. Like and share my videos and then subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. See you in the next video.